You know, I'm gonna give you a history lesson, because I'm sure this wasn't on your entry exam. But every naturalized American has heard something about what I'm about to tell you. A picture is the early 50s in the United States. This 14-year-old boy goes down from Chicago to Mississippi to meet his extended family for the first time. He'd never been to Mississippi. And before he went, his mother said to him, very pointedly, she said, "If a white man looks you in your eyes in Mississippi, look away." And I don't know what you know about black people from Chicago, but they're not a scared people. Legend has it, he was in front of a convenience store hanging out with his cousins, having a good time, and a white woman walked out of the store, and he thought she was pretty, and he said, "Bye, baby." Not realizing that he had just made a fatal mistake. 4 days later, a group of adult white men burst into this family's home and snatched a 14-year-old boy out of bed in front of his family that was powerless to stop them, and he was never seen alive again. His name was Emmett Till. They found his body maybe a few days later. It was in a creek, tied to a wheel so it would sink, horribly beaten and bloated. Hideous. And lucky for everybody in America, his mother was a fucking gangster. She was. If you can imagine, in the very midst of a mother's worst nightmare, this woman had the foresight to think about everybody. She said, "Leave my son's casket open." She said, "The world needs to see what they did to my baby." And every publication here in the United States, from Jet Magazine all the way to the New York Times, had this boy's horribly bloated body on its cover. And if our civil rights movement was a car, this boy's dead body was premium gas. This was a very definitive moment in American history where every thinking and feeling person was like, "Ugh, we gotta do better than this." And they fought beautifully, and here we all are.
Then the police came, I went in the house. Because they got magnums too. And they don't kill cars. They kill niggas. Police got a chokehold they use out here though, man. They choke niggas to death. That mean you be dead when they through. Right, did you know that?
Wait, the niggas going, "Yeah, we know." Wife, "No, I had no idea."
Yeah, two grab your legs, one grab your head, it'll snap.
"Oh shit, he broke." "Can you break a nigger, is it okay?" "Let's check the manual." "Yep, page 8, you can break a nigger right there, see? Let's drag him downtown, okay."
And they got them dogs they sick on your ass, right? Them German shepherds and shit. Nasty motherfuckers, right? Some places they got them Dobermans. Doberman pinchers? Them some bad motherfuckers. They fast, too. Right? Catch the average white boy. By the time they catch a nigga, though, they too tired to do anything. Maybe get petted or some shit like that. "You tired of running, boy? Sit your ass right there, then. I'm gonna get on. You all right?" I saw him let one loose on a young brother about 16 in an alley. Police jumped out the car and sick the Doberman loose on him. The brother was low running. He was down in here. And the dog was on his ass. And it must have got good to the brother because he shifted into overdrive on the dog. Yeah, the brother had a cap on. He just went. And it looked like to me like the dog said, "Shit. Motherfuck that nigga, man. Shit, he gonna kill me out here. Shit. Give me a biscuit, yeah."
was having an interaction with like this homeless dude, right? And he was, you know, begging for money. And I took out $5 and I gave him $5. He looked at me and we're having a conversation. We're having this moment where he's telling me about his life story. His parents were abusive. He ran away from home, got hooked on drugs. And he looks at me and he goes, "Hey man, tell me more about yourself. Where are you from?" I said, "I'm from South Africa." He said, "Where about in Africa is that?" I said, "In the South, as suggested." As suggested on the title of the... So he looks at me, he goes, "Oh, you from Africa, man?" I said, "Yeah, I'm from Africa." He says, "You're from Africa?" I said, yeah, I'm from Africa. And then he gave me my $5 back. I was like, "Yeah, it's fine, okay?" Like, he was like... He just looked at me like, "No, you know what, just take your money. My whiteness will sort this out, don't worry." You know what I mean? And I told this to my friend, and my friend was like, "That's such an offensive thing to happen to you." And I said, "No, that was a special moment because this dude was aware of his privilege as a white dude. He was fully aware. He was like, listen, this is a fucked up situation, but trust me, I do not want to be African." Do you understand what I mean? And it was a beautiful thing, and it's such a hard thing to understand. So I appreciated that dude, right? And here's the thing. I'm going to try to explain what white privilege is in a room full of white people. So wish me luck. This is what white privilege is.
As long as white people can say bad credit, we should be able to say nigga. That's our shit. Oprah talking about, we can't say nigga no more. Come on, Oprah. You own everything. Don't take nigga from us. Don't remember we love you, Oprah, because you a nigga? Did you forget that? Remember Color Purple? Till you do right by me, nigga? That was the shit. Oprah's our nigga.
You need a black friend. You need a black friend. It's 2019. If you don't have a black friend, you're the problem. But if you don't have one, I understand. I understand. It's scary. It is. Because of how we've been portrayed, right? Black people have always been portrayed as sinister, menacing, a threat. Yeah. Haven't you heard about this story? In Chicago, black security guard, right, at a club, there was a shooting. The black security guard apprehended the shooter. The cops show up, shoot the black security guard. Yeah, because all they saw was a black man. Why can't we be the good guy? Black people, we need a better publicist. No, fuck that, we need a publicist. I want the publicist that the white guys use. That publicist kicks ass. That publicist is the best, because they know how to spin it. Even when white guys fuck up, they can spin it. And where you won't think, oh, all white guys are fucked up. No, because they make them individuals. You know, crazy white guy shoots up a movie theater, they give you his backstory, right? Tell you where he went to school. Oh, he was a loner. They put a picture up in the news of him that's so sympathetic. I'm watching news, I'm like, oh man, he should have called me. We need a better publicist. Yeah, I want a campaign, for black people, right? How about like some billboards all across the country of black people just doing fun, non-threatening, frivolous shit. Just black people just like bowling. Just... How about some slogans? You know, like Toys for Tots. How about a good slogan for black people? Hey, let's get black to business. Like that. Or maybe, you know, something environmental, like show black people just taking out the recycling can, you know, like. We're black, but we're green. You need a black friend. Get a black friend, you'll learn some shit. Like, here's an easy one. You should know this one. Never touch a black woman's hair. Yes. Never touch a black woman's hair. I don't give a fuck if she has a tarantula sitting on her head. Let it bite her. Here's another one I'll give y'all. White people, you go and you get a tan. You get a nice tan, you've been on vacation. Do not go back to your job and go up to your black coworker. Hey, Denise. I'm almost there. Hey, girlfriend, I'm almost there. We hate that shit. And we secretly wish bad black shit happens to you when you do it. I'm almost there. Mm-hmm. I hope you get sickle cell.
Here's my question. You would think the cops would occasionally shoot a white kid just to make it look good. You would think that every couple of months they'd look at their dead nigga calendar and go, oh my God, we're up to 16. We gotta shoot a white kid quick. Oh, which one? Ah, the first one you see singing Cardi B. That's right. I mean, honestly, I wanna live in a world with real equality. I wanna live in a world where an equal amount of white kids are shot every month. An equal world. I wanna see white mothers on TV crying, standing next to Al Sharpton, talking about we need justice for Chad. We need justice for Chad. He was just coming home from racquetball practice. I know some people are like, come on, Chris, man, you go too hard on the cops, man. You a celebrity. I'm sure they let you go. I'm sure they nice to you, man. You a celebrity. Yeah, I'm famous, you know. But I'm not like Michael Jackson famous. I'm not famous from miles away. Like, my fame kicks in right about here. You know, when the cops see me walking down the street, they're like, nigga, 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 nigga. Hey, that's Chris Rock. Man, you are funny, man. I love Pootie Tang, man.
Look at this. This is not the Hollywood look. This is not. There's two looks for black women in Hollywood. You either look like Halle Berry or Precious. And there's no. There's no sliding scale. I used to get sent for the most ridiculous auditions when I was in Hollywood. This was an actual audition I got sent for. I'm not even making this up. This was the name of the character. Ghetto Hoochie number 3. I had one line. Do you want to hear the line? Yeah. Nigga is nacho, baby. That was. I said to my agent, I will not say that. I refuse. I will not say it. I got integrity. I'm a black woman. I will not do it. And then I saw the money. And I was like, nigga is nacho, baby. Do you think I'll get promoted to Ghetto Hoochie 1? What do you think? Do you think? So it's good to be back. So I don't know if you, some of you are looking a bit confused. Did you know there were black people in England? Did you know? We are everywhere. You look confused though, sir. You look confused. You're looking up at me like, is that Idris Elba? What is happening? I know, from London, England, born and raised. Because I don't know if you know this, Americans, but the Brits are the best at racism. They're the best. They're better than you, Americans. They're so good, you don't even know you're being discriminated against. They are fucking ninja racist. And that's why I prefer good old-fashioned American racism. Yeah, I said it, America, I prefer it. It's in your face. You know where you stand with American racism. You guys have even made movies to let me know where I'm welcome and where I'm not. For instance, I know I'm never going to fucking Mississippi. I've seen the films. Having said that though, my manager did recently put some shows in my calendar for Birmingham, Alabama. I know. I saw that come up in my calendar and I was like, fuck no! And then I saw the money. And I was like, you know what? We shouldn't be so quick to judge. We should give the people a chance. So I went to Birmingham, Alabama, people. And it was all right. I had a good time. I experienced that southern hospitality. The shows were great, and they put me in a very nice hotel. Very nice. I was very surprised by this. I'll tell you why. I'm from England. All I know about Alabama is from your movies. So I wasn't expecting to be staying in no nice hotel. I was expecting to be staying in a shack on a swamp run by some guy wearing overalls who referred to me as boy. That's what I was expecting. So I was very surprised by the hotel. I was like, oh, this is lovely. This is very civilized. This is wonderful. I basically treated Alabama the way white people treat Africa the first time they go. You know what I'm talking about, white people. You turn up in Africa for the first time, you're like, wow. They have cars and shoes and shit. That's how I was in Alabama. I was like, wow, they have electricity and teeth. This. A lot of black people in Alabama. That shocked me. I was really surprised by that. I was like, wow, a lot of black people. I got off the plane and I saw the black people and I ran up to them. I was like that. You know you can leave, right? You don't even have to go underground. You can just drive. I'm learning a lot.